I first heard about the Voynich manuscript 4 years ago. I must say it had instantly captured my interests.
The thing that got my initial attention, I noticed that there was a significant number of words that started with the same characters but ended with different characters. This pattern was quite familiar to me since I'm originally Turkish.
The Turkish language is an agglutinative one, meaning typically the words contain a root at the beginning and the affixations are added to the root word to create derivative words and sentences. Essentially, this structure was visually very similar to my native Turkish language. I'm an electrical engineer by education and trade. However, reaching an ancient Turkish languages has been a passion of mine for the last 25 years.
I initially identified seven characters by relating them to previously deciphered languages. So the first thing we did was try and identify the characters that were common between the Voynich manuscript and Old Turkic. Some of the Voynich characters are also used in several Proto-European and early Semitic languages. After matching the first seven characters, our next step was to identify those figures and illustrations with unique words labeled next to them.
Here is an example from the astronomical section of the manuscript. The first thing you will notice in folio 67R is that there were 12 segments in this illustration. So the obvious logic was that each of these segments must be representing the months of a year. Our next step was finding all the names of the month in modern and old Turkic languages. Then we plugged in the characters that we had deciphered. Currently, we are able to match five of these months with their corresponding Turkish words. We applied this methodology to the other illustrations, and in doing so, we were able to decipher the remaining characters of the alphabet.
Now, the alphabet that was used to write the Voynich manuscript was comprised of 24 basic letters and over 62 combined letters and tamgas.
Now, going back to my astronomical example, it turned out that at the top it was the month of the December, and the months were ordered clockwise, starting from January all the way to December. For example, the 10th month is October, and in the manuscript it reads as Olguzar, and using the old Turkish dictionaries it translated as Güzay. In modern Turkish, Güz means autumn and Ay means month. The word Ay in Turkish has two meanings, month and moon. Here it is translating as the month of autumn. Then the 11th month, which is November in Voynich, it can be read as Seferü and Seferi, which translated as Sefer Ayı and as Sefer Ayı in modern Turkish. Sefer meaning sprinkling and raining. Another example could be from the 7th month of July, which is read as Çağı Orak in Voynich and as Çağı Orak in modern Turkish. In addition to that, the words Orak and Çorak are both related, as they both refer to the harvesting period of the year. In Old Turkish, one of the meanings Orak directly translates to July, as well as harvesting. The word Çorak means arid season, in other words, harvesting in the rainless season. Similarly, we have identified around 30 words with illustrations.
Now we were convinced that this is simply plain Turkish. We challenged ourselves by translating a full page of text.
Sans la nommer, vous parlez d'elle comme d'une bien-aimée, d'une infidèle, une fille bien vivante qui se réveille.
The Voynich Manuscript. For years, this mysterious document has perplexed scholars and researchers who have all failed at deciphering the handwritten book. There appear at first glance to be six sections: herbal, astronomical, biological, cosmological, pharmaceutical, and recipes. Matching illustrations help to hint at what the writing could signify. With no proper translation of the manuscript yet completed, it has so far been impossible to say for sure where it came from.
Another example of us testing this theory will be found on page 58R. We selected that page off of random, and we selected the first paragraph out of it, which contained 131 words. And out of those 131 words, using this method, we derived 28 of them via just direct translation.
As a result, we currently have found over 300 different words and have deciphered sufficient vocabulary that enable us to read 30% of the entire manuscript.
Now, language and writing structure. The Voynich manuscript was written in a Turkic language, which essentially is an agglutinative one. And the way that works is, essentially, an agglutinative language is one that has words that are comprised of roots and are later affixed through either prefixes or suffixes and or other roots. Now, by doing this, you can either completely vary the definition of the original word, or you can create variations upon it. And what the author did was just that. Now, the author of the manuscript was actually writing in phonemic orthography, which essentially just means that he would spell things essentially just as he would hear them. Now, the text was written from left to right, just as we would read it. And furthermore, once actually read, it becomes quite evident that the author's use of language demonstrates that the language he used was quite poetic in a sense, because there's also a rhythmic structure. For example, on folio 33V, Sunflower Herbal, if you really follow the text, each and every line is rhythmically matching.